space, the boundary of human achievement, the new frontier.
It's just a cough.
Yeah, right. And the earth is flat.
Treat your cough seriously with Robitussin CF Max. Nothing lasts longer and treats more symptoms for your cough, cold, and flu. Robitussin, because it's never just a cough.
In a few moments, you will have an experience which will seem completely real. It will be the result of your subconscious fears transformed to your conscious awareness. Warning, this tape must not be played by government personnel. It can be extremely harmful and result in severe trauma. You have 5 seconds to terminate this tape. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
The world's still round. I'm here to tell you it's not. It's flat.
Lexi, tell us something interesting.
Okay, the earth is flat. And a witch stole his pants.
Flat Earth expert Mark Sargent thinks the moon landing was a hoax.
Technically, the moon itself is a hoax.
Right, but betting with Sportsbet's new iPhone app?
I could do this standing on my head.
Thanks, Gravity. Sportsbet's new iPhone app. It's foolproof.
Oh, hold on. I know how we're different. Do you believe the Earth is flat?
I know it's flat. I walk on it.
Holy shit.
The earth is flat,
it's a flat world after all.
Smoke weed every day.
Are we resetting? We're now in. Hopefully they won't restart the music. Okay. Anyway, so the point was, we got, even after this is over, I got exactly one email from Professor Dave, sub guy, and it was even after that. Even he didn't watch it. And Professor Dave, I thought, would have thrown something at me considering the comments I put in there. Oh, God, it's so horrible. The point was, it was almost unwatchable because he resorted to name-calling within the first 5 minutes, and he never stopped.
Nope.
He just used the same words over and over. Stupid, idiot, moron.
Mm-hmm.
All just constantly just attacking to where even non-flat earthers in the comment section going, So are you actually going to debate something, or are you just going to go after, you know, I mean, he is a pro troll. That's all he is.
Yeah.
He was just smiling and yelling, you know, and calling Dave names, and Dave wasn't biting on it. Good for you, Dave. I couldn't have done it. I would have called out the moderators. And by the way, a little backstory here. I was asked to be on this and they didn't tell me who it was. And they said, we got an anti, and I felt like a troll trap. So I said, yeah, I'm not interested at all. And then they did the same thing to Dave, and they said, oh, no, we'll moderate it. Well, there was no moderation at all.
No.
They turned off their mics and just let those two guys go at it.
Yeah.
And it was, no, Dave crushed it. He absolutely crushed it. And again, the proof was in for me in the numbers, which is like, okay, you have 2 million subs. Where the hell? Why did we own the chat room? Why do we own the chat sec? You know, the comment section.
Because his subs are fake. If you go and look at the views he gets on his videos that he puts out on his channel, his crappy videos don't get anywhere near the amount of views they should get if he really has 2 million subs. His videos get like 5,000 or 6,000 views tops.
Yep. Yeah, which is what I get. You know, right, with my paltry and you know, I haven't even had 100,000 subs yet. And I made a perspective thing where I said, look, one of the premier rock music interview channels called Loudwire. They even do music videos. They just interview rock people, right? He has more subs than they do. They have 1.8 million. And they're going to probably hit a billion views before the year's out. And he doesn't even have a fifth of their numbers. Anyway, long story short, Professor Dave, total fraud. Don't ever call me again.
Yeah.
Okay, let's get to the headlines. Where we got for headlines? All right. Let's start out with this is, of course, the show is called Double Dog Dare, not to be confused with Triple Dog Dare. And if you're not old enough to remember the wonderful Christmas movie called A Christmas Story, the saber rattling, lots of saber rattling happening in the background, and we're going to get to it. So there's lots of posturing. War hasn't broken out. I'll let you guys know when it starts to break out, but it hasn't broken out yet. So the first one is Joe Biden just, you know, putting foot in mouth. And his first one, he was talking to the labor unions. This is from the Washington Examiner. And he says, hey, if I got to go to war, I'm going with you guys. That's great. That's a wonderful optimistic thing you want to throw at the labor unions. Yeah, talk to blue collar and tell them that basically we're going to war. Next one down. And this is somebody late to the game. This is from Fox Business. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen. That's a wonderful deer in a headlight thumbnail for her. Staring, saying that, hey, there could be enormous economic repercussions from Ukraine invasion. You think? Yellen? Yeah, great look from you. Yeah, she's going to do well. I guarantee it. Next one down. We're just going to punch through these till the break. If you want to know where the solidarity is not in the American people, but is in the government people. They have apparently forgot about everything. So this is from UPI News. Senate votes 100-0. To strip Russia of normal's trade status. And you're probably saying, Mark, it's kind of a boring story. Why would you put this in there? Because you don't see 100-0 in the government about really anything. This is the ultimate peer pressure right here. Nobody from either side of the floor didn't want to raise their hand on this. It's like, no, Russia bad, vote. Russia bad, vote. No one wants to go against this. You don't want to be that guy because the narrative's out there. Russia bad, Russia bad. Okay, moving on. Next one down. This is from RT.com. If you guys haven't gone to RT.com, please do. It stands for Russia Today, and it will be banned in America one of these days. Not yet, though. So until then, EU nation says it's ready to pay rubles for Russian gas. Please see some of the previous shows we've done on how that works. Hungary has gotten in there and said, yeah, you know what? We're totally doing it. We're totally fine with it. And again, every country that signs on to this is going to push us closer to the big showdown because, every time this happens, the U.S. dollar will start losing ground. Maybe not in the direct exchange rate, but it's going to start losing. It already has. Moving on. Next one down. Russian energy paid for. Oh, yeah. This is a good one. Also from Russia Today. Russian energy paid for in yuan. That's the Chinese money. Yuan is heading to China. Yep, you're not going to see this in American media. Coal cargoes will arrive this month, followed by crude oil in May. China shares a big border with Russia, and it's like, yeah, fine. Again, remember, they're not on the unfriendly list. Russia's got an unfriendly list. They got a friendly list. China, friendly. They can pay whatever they want. Chinese yuan, and that's why they're writing the story. It's like, yeah, China can pay in yuan. You guys over there, yeah, you can't. Nope. Nope, nope. China, good. China, good. All you idiots, bad. Moving on. Next one down. Oh, propaganda piece from America. This is American media, so it is going to be propaganda. This is from News. I've never seen it spelled that way, but it must be legit because it's American. Majority of the United States okay with increased costs because of the conflict in Ukraine. So everyone's fine. You understand what this story says. All the Americans are fine with inflation because we value Ukraine's freedom. Anyone here
stupid
buying
Americans.
That?
Yep. Yeah. No, stupid Americans.
Americans don't care. Americans do not care. They look at the gas pump. They look at the price of hot dogs. They look at the price of all this stuff. They don't care about Ukraine. They care about it when it's convenient for them. But when gas hits $6 a gallon, they do not care. Screw your freedoms. Screw Ukraine. Seriously. So that's a wonderful propaganda piece. Next one down. And I didn't know this, but Shell Oil is pulling away from Russia. So they apparently own a $5 billion stake in Russian assets, right? What I did not know is that Shell Oil isn't American. It's British. Did not know that. I mean, everyone's heard of like British Petroleum. I thought Shell Oil was a big American company. They are not. They are a British company. So there you go. And why are they pulling away? Because the UK is America's friend. Remember, when it comes to NATO, UK is our best bud. They would also like to sock Hitler on the jaw. All right, next one down. Also an RT story. We've got a few of these. The U.S. can't replace Russian coal supplies to Europe. Now, what I mean by that is we also heard the stuff earlier in the year about how we can't, you know, you can't replace Russian oil. You can't replace Russian coal or gas. Well, apparently, because Russia does a lot of coal business, they also make a lot of coal equipment and supplies to go with it. And nobody else does. So even if you could replace the coal, you don't have all the doodads to go with it. So now what do you do? So now the European Union's like, where do we get all our parts for the coal stuff? It's, I don't know. Ask the Americans. Yeah, it's not going well. All right, next one down. Oh, yeah. So you remember last week, Karen, when we said to India, hey, stop leaning on Russia so much for energy stuff? You know, like gas and oil. Mm-hmm. Maybe you remember that, maybe you don't. Well, now the United States has said, and this is from RT.com, U.S. warns India over Russian weapons. Washington will require, let's see how that goes, India to buy U.S. weapons instead. Let me read a
what?
Paragraph. No, I'm not making this up. U.S. Secretary of Defense said on Tuesday that India's continued purchase of Russian weapon systems is not in their best interest, quote unquote, and there will be a requirement, quote unquote, that leaders in India swap some of these systems for U.S. and allied weapons. India is the world's largest military importer and counts on Russia for nearly half of its supply of weaponry. And so see, Austin responded to blah, 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 who described India as a treasured ally of the U.S. and the world's largest democracy. And that we've got the U.S. has the finest weapon systems in the world and would offer them to India. OK, long story short, we're doing everything we can here, but India is not dumb. And yes, does America have some of the best weapon systems in the world? You bet. But they're also very expensive and very complicated, right? So what are you going to do? You're going to go out there and buy a $5,000 refrigerator that'll wake you up in the middle of the night and do all these weird things for you? Or are you going to buy the $900 fridge from Walmart or whoever sells fridges in your area? That's all India cares about. It's like, does it shoot? Does it run? Does it work? Fine, that's all right. We care. That's what Russians known for, is weapons that work, that are cheap, you know, and they're not flashy. They're not shiny and black and have all these electronic things. They just work. Moving on. All right, next one down. Let's we got a couple more before the break, definitely. Oh, so this one is Finland. Okay, this is from the Daily Mail. This is a British thing. Finland will be asking for their destruction of their country if they join NATO and make themselves a Russian target, says Moscow. It's kind of a wordy way. I'm sure it was the way the translation goes, but let's jump to the map, shall we? So the map in question, if you pull this up on screen, is if you're looking on screen, it's called, you can look, if you're just listening to the audio version, it's called NATO's expansion since 1997. And I actually didn't know all of these by heart. So the purple is what happened before 1997. That was NATO. And then you see what we've done since 97. And it has been significant. Right. All these countries, Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania, Poland, Czech Republic, Slovakia, Hungary, Romania, Slovenia, Croatia, Montenegro. I didn't know that was a country. I thought it was a city. Albania, North Macedonia. Oh, those damn Macedonians. And Bulgaria. Right. Mm-hmm. And then Finland on this map is right above number one, if I'm not mistaken, which borders Russia, which is why they care. Okay, they don't want Finland, it borders Russia, and right next to that, the other gray one next to there is Sweden, and then you have Norway, which is already involved. So, why is this important? If you go down to the very next story, I love this, which is, this is from the Daily Mail, Russia moves heavy military equipment towards Finnish border. Why would they do that? Russian heavy weapons, including missile systems, have been moving towards the border with Finland hours after Russia warned its northern neighbor against joining NATO. Blah, blah, blah. A lot of posturing, but I have no doubt that they're moving stuff up there. Because, again, if you're bordering anything with Russia, which is why, and if you're looking at that map also, you'll notice that two countries really stack out. Belarus, which is absolutely with Russia, and the big one in the middle, which is Ukraine. You want to know why Russia's so keen on keeping that in their neck of the woods? That's why. It's because they border, it borders a lot of countries and the Black Sea. Big, big deal for them. And Finland, no slouch either. I mean, it's up in the north, but they're not going to let it go. So yeah, Finland, I do not recommend you guys joining NATO anytime soon. Okay, got a few minutes till the break. What else we got? Let's switch over. We can do a few of these before the break. Let's switch over to the Chinese side of things. Remember, we haven't forgotten about Taiwan. Oh, no. It's still early in the year. It's only April. So the first thing was a story from MSN. And in fact, it was out of Reuters. China warns the U.S. against House Speaker Pelosi visiting Taiwan. You're probably thinking, that's odd. That seems sort of random. One, why would Pelosi be going to Taiwan? And two, why would they care? Well, was that me? Sorry. You know how the video is autoplay if you scroll down far enough. And it's still autoplaying, you little piece of crap. Stop playing. Oh, my God. All right. I got to kill that. You could probably hear that whole music thing, couldn't you?
No, I couldn't hear it.
Oh, thank God. All right. Well, anyway, the deal was apparently the House Speaker has not been to Taiwan in years and years and years. And China says if House Speaker Pelosi goes, it's a symbolic gesture that basically says you're acknowledging Taiwan as an independent country. Review, Taiwan is officially part of China. And China eventually is going to take it back and probably, you know, just run their flags on it. But until then, anyone that says, well, you remember what happened with, John Cena, right? Mm-hmm. He accidentally said that oh, yeah, we're going to be doing a premiere in Taiwan, too. And, you know, the country of Taiwan. You're not even supposed to say country of Taiwan. China just loses it, just freaking loses. It's like, they're not a country. They're part of ours. They're not a country. So yeah, they're kind of ticked off about that. So Pelosi, I don't think she's going anywhere. I mean, it was just a rumor that she was going over there, and they started losing it.
She should go.
The what?
She should go.
She should go. She should go. I don't think she's going now. No, if Moscow throws that sort of thing out there, she's not that brave. Like, what would be the benefit of going? The potential of her being, you know, held hostage or worse. Okay, we got time for at least one more. Okay, so what else happening in Taiwan? This is not just one thing. The next one down is from RT, which is U.S. greenlights new Taiwan arms deal. Washington is expected to provide Taiwan with training and equipment to support its Patriot air defense systems. So all of a sudden, out of nowhere, the Patriot missile system, which is already there, by the way, we have a lot of weapons already there, kind of like we shipped over to Ukraine, but a little different. We're going to be upgrading those. Yeah. Just coincidentally, right now. We're gonna be upgrading those. And if you scroll down to the very next one, this may be the last one before the break. Yeah, the last one before the break. We're introducing a brand new, this is from a local story out of Paducah, Cape Girard. The Taiwan Weapons Export Act is being put across the floor. I guarantee it'll pass, which is it's basically removes all red tape. So it's a big expedite. So if you want to send anything to Taiwan, forget about the red tape. You can ship it right. Get it on a boat today. Go. Wow. Why would America do that? Why would we do that? I don't know. I know why, and we'll talk about it when we come back. Okay. And then we'll do more headlines, and then we'll take some phone calls. And then segment four, we're going to bring in Zulu One early and see what he has to rant about. Phone number, by the way, to call in is 213-233-3998. That's 213-233-3998. And are we good on TFR? Yes. Peanut says we are good. I'm
not hearing any music.
No, it's because we haven't hit it yet. Because officially it should be here in 5, 4, 3. Of course, what are the odds that's going to actually kick in? Uh-oh. Do we have music? Hey, look at that.
Oh,
we got music.
Finally.
Yeah. Hey, we'll be back in 3 minutes. Don't go anywhere.
Frequency Radio.
We are TFR.
Welcome back to Strange World Part 2 of 4. It's you, me, and the lovely Karen B. And yeah, you know what that was? Joe Jackson stepping out from his album.
Night and Day.
Yeah, and they're not on tour, by the way, Joe Jackson this year. However, the Deftones are, and for the TFR listeners that may have missed it, the Deftones have started the U.S. and Canada tours. They will be in Portland, Oregon, day after tomorrow, April 14th. They will be in Seattle on the 16th, and they will be in San Francisco on the 18th. You can check that out at deftonestour.com. And if you go, throw a flat sign at Stefan and see if he throws it back.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah. Okay. Also, let's do the meetups since we got thrown for the first part of the show because we didn't even know if we were on. So there are going to be some meetups. Obviously, there's going to be one in Oklahoma on the 16th. That's coming up this weekend. Truth or Chloe and Jesse will be hosting a meetup with Peanut Gallery on the 16th, this Saturday, all day at Hummingbird Beach in Lake Eufaula State Park in Oklahoma. Feel free to come early, stay late, lots of great things, blah, 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 Nikon P1000. And then RSVP by calling Jesse at 857-344-6209 or Chloe at 405-614-2250. You can also email them at 300kmileprius@gmail.com or chloerebecca@gmail.com. That's chloerebekah@gmail.com. And sorry, there's also meetups in Florida, in Tampa, Jupiter, and Daytona this weekend, and the schedule is on flatearthfestivals.com. Yep.
That's right.
And there's also two more, but not this weekend. They're both on my channel. You can see the promos for these. There's going to be one in South Carolina, April 30th. You can check out the promo for that on my channel at Mark K. Sargent, or the meetup on April 30th in Ohio. And yeah, if you're there, sub while you're at it so that I can actually hit 100,000 subs officially before the war starts. It'd be kind of nice. I know it's petty, but I'm a petty guy. All right, I think that's it, right? Peanut, did I miss anything? I don't think I missed anything at the moment. All right, let's get back to the headlines. Let's stay over in China.
China.
I'll never be able to say it right because of him, by the way. RT.com, China beefs up nukes to deter U.S. threat. Yep. Wall Street Journal has cited anonymous Chinese officials and satellite imagery of Beijing's missile silos. So China is, you know, they're just beefing up the nukes just in case. I like how they're just going to casually throw that out there. You know,
beef up nukes.
Yeah, in case we
whatever.
Whatever. Yeah. So let's next one down simultaneously. We got two more China ones. First is Taiwan, just out of the blue, is conducting military games right now. They're checking their air defense readiness. Why would they do that now? Why? Why would you care about air defense readiness in Taiwan? Ah, I don't know. So read it if you get a chance. I'm sure the American advisors there are keeping busy. And last but not least, here's something really interesting, which I wasn't going to run, but when it showed up on the government website, the China Travel Advisory, yikes. They weren't kidding about that. Remember we were talking about those lockdowns a couple of shows ago that are happening down in China where they're just locking down cities? I mean, hard. Where
they're doing it to Shanghai right now. Did you see all the stuff coming out of Shanghai?
Yeah, that gave me a few chills, the whole screaming out the window bit.
Yeah,
was eerie. I mean, that was movie worthy because it's like, yeah, that's what they would do too. You know, you would get, I mean, I've seen movies where it's on a smaller scale, but not like that.
Yeah, it was weird because then somebody's like, oh, it's fake. And I'm like, well, think about, okay, if it is fake, how are they faking that?
Yeah, nope, that is not fake. If you lock people in an apartment building, I mean, literally lock them in when they can't get out and they starting, you know, because cabin fever is a real thing. Look it up. People lose it.
Yeah.
People start losing it. Anyway, so we basically, travelstate.gov has issued a China travel advisory. And I love it. When you look at the thing, it's orange level, and it says reconsider travel. I got to read this first paragraph here. Ready? This was just yesterday. They put this out here. Reconsider travel is the People's Republic of China due to arbitrary enforcement of local laws and virus-related restrictions. I'm not going to say the word. Do not travel to China's Hong Kong Special Administrative Region, Jilin Province, and Shanghai Municipality due to virus-related restrictions, including the risk of parents and children being separated. Reconsider travel to Hong Kong SAR due to also arbitrary enforcement of local laws. So what China's doing is, on just a moment's notice, they can lock you down. And I mean, we've seen stuff of, you know, they'll put tape and bars across the windows and that's it. They don't mess around. And of course, the Americans would never go along with something like this. But if you're in China, if you're thinking of going over there, which you probably shouldn't do, head straight for the freaking embassy. If you start hearing alarm, you know, purge alarm sounds going off, because I don't know what it is about them, but the fact that they're willing to actually be locked in, you know, you can lock down an entire city like that. Amazing. Okay, enough of China. Let's go swing back over here. Let's see what the Americans are doing and other countries are doing about the whole Ukraine thing. First off, let's go for the petty and the obvious because this is straight up propaganda. But you know what? It's the little things, which is this is from, I think it's RT. Is it? Yeah, RT. Boston Marathon bans runners from Russia.
So why? Stupid.
I know, and of course, they also haven't thought about the longer – I'm sure somebody's thought about it, which is this isn't like Japan in 1941 where we set up internment camps. There are a lot of Russian people that live in America, a lot.
Oh, yeah.
What are you going to do if this actually happens? Do you even know who the Russians are? It's different when they're Japanese, right? And in the 1940s, they stick out like a sore thumb. Russians in America now, they could be walking right by the street. You have no idea who they are. Could be your neighbor. Yeah. So Russia is being banned by Boston Marathon. Next one down, France. Freaking French people. They're preparing gas rationing because they don't know what to do. I heard a rumor that they were actually just going to start surrendering next week, just rolling over. Let them land, which is weird because Russia doesn't border France, but they were thinking of surrendering anyway. Next one down. This is from the quote of the day, which is also from RT. Why do Europeans have to sacrifice hot showers to stick it to Putin? Love the thumbnail there, which is they're trying to convince Europe again, like the war's already in progress. Before, in the 1940s, there were a lot of sacrifices that were made all over the place. Like, we're going to do food cards and you got to sacrifice metal, metal drives and stuff like that. They're already starting some of this in Europe. They're saying, oh, you got to take shorter showers. They even take showers in France? I don't know. All right, moving on. Next one down. Over here in America. Oh, so speaking of sacrifices, we'll do a quick little inflation thing, which is – so the next one down, all these signs saying steaks can't be sold due to theft. So if inflation – you guys probably didn't know this, or maybe you did, just didn't occur to you, which is as inflation gets higher and higher, more items become shoplifting worthy. So right now, depending on what store you're at, they might have cigarettes and alcohol behind plexiglass or some of the electronics, and you have to ask somebody to unlock it, and they have to go get it for you because, they don't want somebody just clearing out stuff into a bag and running away with it. Well, meat has – certain cuts of meat have gotten up to a certain level to where people are just, stuffing them in purses and walking out with them. So because of that, there was a little TikTok video there, I think, which saying that due to high theft, we can no longer put steaks on the shelf. Please ask associates if needed. Yep, luxury items. And the next one down, which is different, but I'm not exactly sure who to make of it, which is – this is from dailymail.com. Walgreens is rationing baby formula. As supply chain crunch hits new parents, 29% of the top selling formulas are out of stock at stores across the U.S. So they're limiting the purchase of bit. Now, that doesn't mean we're not talking about huge shortage. I think if you could buy three off the shelf, you could leave and go back to your car and then come back in. I don't think they're going to stop you there. But yeah, that's kind of weird. All right. Next one down. Making light of it. Next one down is an opinion. And that is from the LA Times. It's always the LA Times that has these opinions. Southern California just shouldn't write opinions. You know why? Because this one's ridiculous. Opinion. Do we try to prevent? Yeah, I know. a mass grave. So the headline here is, do we try to prevent World War III or is it already here? And I was doing my best trying to do a California thing there. It's true. So what do you think? World War III? Yeah? Maybe? It's not that I want the earthquake to happen and Los Angeles to fall into the ocean. I don't.
Yeah.
But part of me does. All right, let's we got a few left. We're gonna try to end some lighter notes. First one is a UK booklet. And again, we do not have a lucky or unlucky list this week, even though 30 minutes before the show, Gilbert Gottfried died.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. No and Peanut and I were going through the list and then all of a sudden I go, holy smokes, Gilbert Gottfried just died from a quote unquote long illness. But if you look at his resume, he had all sorts of projects that were still happening. So whatever this long illness was, he still could work. So I'm going to call maybe BS on that one. Maybe. And by the way, if you're calling in tonight, do not call me and ask me about the water thing. Please try to refrain from that. If I get one more freaking email about the...
Yeah.
Whew. I've gotten email from family members, from friends.
Should always be highly suspicious when anything goes viral that quickly.
Yeah.
About especially a subject like that.
Yeah. Yeah,
just when be highly suspect of
that. Yeah, when it's a bombshell like that, and you know,
produced dramatic music.
Yeah, dramatic music was just like, come on, and even, I mean, the fact that you had to make a trailer for it, come on. If it's that big, you just release it. You don't studio it. You don't put dramatic music behind it. You don't do the whole close-up shock and awe on your face. This is huge. If you have to say this is huge, it's not. Right? It's either huge on its own and it has that much weight behind it or it doesn't. Okay, so the UK book. So horrible UK booklet for kids telling. So anyway, the point was, long story short, is we don't have a lucky unlucky list, but we do have a couple interesting stories here. This is from the UK Health Security Agency, and this is a booklet for parents, right?
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, I think the white girl there on the left has way too much makeup.
Yeah, what is going on here?
It's like, okay, I understand the demographics here, but what's it? What's with the little beauty pageant there on the left? What's happening? Okay, so anyway, in this booklet, they happen to mention to parents, I'm going to be careful here in case you're trying to stream this on YouTube or whatever.
I'm not on YouTube.
You are or aren't?
I'm not.
Okay. Less common side effects. Cases of inflammation of the heart, called myocarditis or pericarditis, have been reported very rarely after virus vaccines. Most cases recovered and felt better following simple treatments. But they're saying so far only 1 to 2 cases of myocarditis have been reported for every million doses of the shot given. Uh-huh. But you should seek medical advice urgently if your child experiences chest pain, shortness of breath, and other crap, you know, and then a phone number to call. So they're saying, oh, it's totally rare, but it could happen. And then the second to the next one down after that, and this one tickled me even more. This is on the American side of things. From Eat This, Not That. Drink this much water each day to prevent heart failure. Okay, so along with all the other stuff we've been told that you're gonna make your heart just drop, if you don't drink enough water, heart attack.
Yep. Of course.
Yep. I mean, honestly, it's starting to sound like a Jeff Foxworthy routine, which is, you know, if you don't drink too much water and you have a heart attack, it might be, you know, it might be the virus.
Whatever.
No, I've never heard that before in my life. People say all the time, be hydrated. I've never heard anyone ever say, if you don't drink enough water, you could just drop dead of a heart attack.
Everything causes heart problems these days.
That's remember, amazing.
even the time change.
Yep. Daylight savings time, which is why we have to get rid of it, because it's just people are just dropping dead.
That's right.
Okay. The last two. Our clown world, straight up clown world. The first one, and I will have Master Gunner put a comment to me in chat because I know he's listening, which is, although extremely dangerous, this is from Popular Mechanics. Popular Mechanics, you guys should know better. Even though extremely dangerous, the Molotov cocktail allows even an untrained civilian to take on a tank. Okay. You guys don't know what a Molotov cocktail is. It's a bottle with a rag filled with alcohol with a rag stuck partially down the bottle so it soaks up. You touch a lighter to it and you throw it at whatever you want. I have never seen in my life, even in the movies, you don't see somebody walking up to a tank with a Molotov and taking it out. Could you throw some fire on it? Sure. Is that fire going to do anything other than tick them off? No, probably not. And if you're coming in from 100 yards out, in fact, I dare you. There's your TikTok challenge for you. You want a TikTok challenge? Find some National Guard tanks. Start from 100 yards away with a Molotov. See how close you get. Real, you know, a Bitcoin. Anyone that can hit the tank and live. No, it's absolutely, absolutely ridiculous. In fact, yes, Master Gunner said in all caps and using profanity that he disagrees. With this statement, because he was a tanker. He knows full well. It's like, no, tanks are meant. The whole point is tanks do very well against infantry. And you're saying guy without a gun, a civilian with no training, with a bottle of alcohol and fire can really hurt a tank. Okay.
Yeah.
And last but not least, and he goes, go ahead. I double dog dare you.
Oh, yes. My gosh.
Yeah. And last but not least, this one I just loved, which was from RT.com, Russia will return to the moon, says Putin. I'm going to read part of this. Sanctions won't derail the country's plan in space. Russia must be able to respond to challenges in exploring space, President Putin said, adding that the country is going to continue with its lunar program, among other ventures. We'll resume the lunar program, he asserted when he was visiting Russia's far eastern region on Tuesday. He said he's referring, of course, to the launch of the Luna 25 robotic lander, which is scheduled to take place on August 22nd, according to the spacecraft developer. And if you scroll down, that's a lovely computer image of that. Actually, that's a terrible computer image of that. It's all gold lander on the moon. Notice how big, by the way, how big the Earth is in the background there.
And they put it upside down. I mean, not that there's an up or a down on a ball, but
right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Can you tell? That's India pointing up.
They're terrible at this. They're absolutely terrible. The probe will be tasked with perfecting a soft landing on the surface for future missions and studying the area near the moon's south pole. It's planned to carry 30 kilograms of scientific equipment. Blah, blah, blah. Never, ever going to happen. What I thought was interesting about this article, though, is that most RT articles, because they have their own comment section, which people can post in down below. If you scroll down to the comment section, it doesn't end. People, this is what we did, by the way. People, any NASA stories, any space stories, they just go at it. And so, yeah, lots and lots and lots of comments down there about how much BS this is. And they also mentioned, by the way, if you guys didn't already realize this, that humanity's exploration of the moon began with the Soviet Luna 2 in 1959, but the country hasn't carried out similar missions for almost five decades. Uh-huh. Why? Why not? Why haven't you been there since 1959? God, even the Americans say they went up until 1972. What happened to you guys? Oh, right. You never went. Ever. So, yeah, this is their little... again, this is just a propaganda story to say. It's not only are we doing an invasion, and not only did we, you know, recalibrate the ruble, and not only are we just doing great, but you know what? We're going to continue with our space program, too. What else are you guys going to be doing? Making movies? Probably. I actually like the shot of him in the background there, you know, in that all white giant room, you know, with rockets. The
rockets, yeah. Yeah,
rockets and the six Russian flags behind him. Though, don't forget, by the way, that Russia's colors are red, white, and blue stripes.
That's right.
Yeah. Okay. So there you go. That's all the headlines. Believe it or not. Okay. Did I miss anything? Is there anything else? We got the meetups, we got the headlines, we got the shout-outs. Anything else before we pick up some calls?
Flattoberfest?
Hey, let's do Hey, Karen, what's happening with Flattoberfest? Not to be confused with the South Carolina meetup on the 30th of this month.
Right. The meetup is different. Oh, you know what? Also, since we're talking about meetups, I did get an email to post a meetup that the Flat Earth Brothers are putting on. You know the Flat Earth Brothers, which had changed their name to the Founded Earth Brothers?
Yeah.
They are putting on a meetup in Ringgold, Georgia. Ringgold, Georgia. April 24th, 2022, from 12 to 9 p.m., and there's an address and everything at my website at flatearthfestivals.com under the Flat Earth Friendly Meetups tab. And then also there's Flat Earth Festival, Flattoberfest 2022 going on, which is going to be October 22nd and 23rd with a big meetup at the park the day before on the 21st. And I have a basic schedule and up on the website and some hotel info, and tickets are on sale for the month of April. So if you know you want to go, there you go. Get your tickets now while they're on sale. That's
And I am going to do everything I can to be there this year.
Yeah, awesome.
I have
Jason Lindgren already said that he wants to be a part of it again, so he'll be doing playing music again.
And I may only do a Q&A just because, you know, presentations, I don't know. We'll see if I do a presentation or if I just do a Q&A.
You do a presentation.
I do or don't?
No, you don't have to.
Okay. I'm just saying that most of the time it's just a recap anyway. Well, we haven't done much over the most of the time we haven't done a lot in the community in the last 2 years because of all the lockdown stuff. And so the highlight reel wouldn't be I love doing highlight reels, but there hasn't been a ton. I mean, there's been a few people here and there, but I'd love to just talk to people. And I think Q&As work pretty well.
Yeah.
I enjoy doing them. So but we'll see. The only thing that's going to stop me right now is the mandates. And I don't think they're going to kick in. I think everything's going to be fine. Other people think, oh, there's going to be new mandates. Going, I don't think so. I think people are done with that. The Americans are especially done with that. China?
Yeah, so you don't think that the shenanigans they're pulling in Shanghai are going to spill over to here?
No. America, you know full well. There's certain things. I mean, think of all the mandates that didn't go through just because of the unions. And look how fast they caved in for the Postal Service and then the truckers and then all the other groups. They're like, okay, you're exempt. It's like by the time they were done, there were so many exempt groups that they realized, like, yeah, we're not going to be able to take this much further. Not in the States. Other countries, yeah, not as – but America, we've always been – to remind people that are listening outside this country or maybe inside, like we didn't even adopt the metric system. That's how we just don't go along with things. I think we just turned off the metric system. It's like, yeah, we're fine with what we got. We don't need it. Everybody else went to the metric system, not us.
So, yeah.
I was old. I was in sixth grade when they tried to roll that out it was the 1970s, and it was like all these multiples of 10, and it's like even the teacher's like, it's just like it didn't have anything to it. You know, we like our ounce and our yard and our foot and our inch and all these, you know, they had personality. The metric system just seemed too generic. There's nothing, it had no pop. All right, enough. Let's pick up some phone. Oh, you know, we can't pick up any phone calls. We've already run out of time. So we'll pick up phone calls on the other side of the break. What else can we talk about?
I don't know. Go to flatearthfestivals.com and get your tickets for Flattoberfest. That's what we can talk about.
There you go. Oh, and I've updated all my copyright issues on my channel on YouTube because there was a bunch of them. I didn't realize that there was a bunch of them that were blocked because I included a visual clip from a Rammstein video where they were reproducing the moon landing. Mm-hmm. And they blocked like 50 of my videos. Not that it matters. I mean, I've got 1,500 videos on my channel, but I made just about every one of them Creative Commons, Commons licenses. So anyone that wants, you can grab any of my videos and put them anywhere you want. I do not care. I've never thrown a strike. I never will. Don't care if you mash them up and do awful things to them. You know, go nuts. So there you go. Okay. With that, I promise we will take phone calls when we come back because Peanut's now bugging me. He's got 40 seconds. So the phone number to call in is 213-233-3998. That's 213-233-3998. Operators are standing by. That means me. So be nice, because remember, no matter where you go, there you are. And the music should have kicked in. Oh, sorry. 3, 2. What do you mean 20 seconds? I don't see 20 seconds. The music should be here like in 3 seconds. There we go. See?
There it goes.
Yeah, I see it. Beat it.
Everything's all off now.
Well, talk to him. All right, back in 3. His face is in the muck. I think his zipper's stuck.
Hi, my name is Ella.
This is the Truth Frequency Radio Network.
We are TFR.
Truth Frequency Radio.
control with us. It's a control with us. Let's roll.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 3 of 4. It's you, me, and the always lovely and sometimes violent Karen B. I don't even describe that picture you sent me. I mean, I realize you're on a farm, but so do you eat that exactly?
I guess you could.
But you're not going to.
I haven't decided yet.
Was this rooster bugging you?
Yeah, he was a bad rooster.
Yeah, my sister has actually done the same thing, but she usually just leaves them out and the birds of prey will find that rooster and then snuff them. Okay, let's pick up phone calls. Phone number to call in is 213-233-3998. That's 213-233-3998. Let's go straight to 646, line unmuted, New York. What is happening out in the Big Apple?
Dude, I've been on hold for like an hour.
This is true. You have been on hold for 56 minutes.
That's bullshit.
Well, you could talk to our complaint department, but I don't think Karen's going to like
it. You can lodge a complaint with Star Command.
Hey, welcome to, what is it? Is it Taco Tuesday or is it False Flag Tuesday? What do you think?
No, it's Taco Tuesday. False Flag isn't happening yet.
I mean, did you look at that thing?
I think there was.
We're not even supposed to say the term, just so you know.
Oh.
Are we on YouTube or what the fuck are we on?
I don't even know what you're referring to. No, there's no YouTube.
There's no YouTube live, but this will go up on YouTube eventually.
I don't even know where this broadcast goes, honestly. I just sit here and talk to you guys and like, okay, it's going somewhere. Somebody's hearing this shit somewhere.
This thing gets reproduced quite a bit. It gets reproduced Rockfin and Rumble, Brideon, BitChute, Odyssey.
So Twitch, Facebook.
All right. So those of you not know, Nintendo, apparently somebody fucking threw a smoke bomb.
The what?
Okay. All right. Somebody threw a smoke bomb on a train today and shot a bunch of people. And it just is the same. It's the same script. Over and over again. It's just like, okay, well, yeah. Maybe that happened, and maybe there's a bunch of actors down there with a smoke bomb, and the internet is ripping it apart. It's just like, you know, I just can't. You know, I just can't. I don't have any more.
That story's not going to get a lot of traction anyway, because nobody died.
Yeah, nobody died, and then it was just dumb. Like, the blood on the subway floor was way too red. It was Hollywood red. It was Hollywood red blood. And it's just like, I just can't. Like, how many times do I have to watch this thing over and over and over again until it's like the kid that's like grabs the hot, you know, the hot handle of a pot, and they look back at you and like, my hand is burning. It's like, well, let go of the fucking pot. Let go of the pot. Like, it's just like, this is going over and over again, you know? Anyway, that was my day today. How are you guys doing?
Yeah. Yeah. I had to watch that. I was getting an oil change. And it was in the waiting area. There was on
Wait, were you
Fox
in like,
News.
A, like the you were like in the there's an oil change. Is it also like a car wash? The car wash oil change?
No, this was just a local shop that had just opened down the street, and just wanted to. I had my car has almost no miles on it, so I figured
they
I'd
like
do
a,
it before.
Like a little smell good. Like smell good thingies that you can put like hang from your mirror. You know,
it was a decent place. No, all they did was basically oil changes. Anyway, what else is happening with you?
Nothing, man. I was just wanted to wish happy False Flag Tuesday. And
it's not False Flag.
That thing. And I mean, there's so many other things to talk about, but it's just not like enough time to do it. So, you know, all I really do is get on here and just run my mouth, and then you guys talk back at me.
You can always come to the after show. I noticed you weren't there last week.
Well, that's another conversation for another day. But what I will say is that I do miss the shit out of you guys, and I don't get enough of you. And like, just after, like, you just mentioned that meetup, and I was like, Mark, what time signature are you in? The meetup happened like 2 weeks ago in New York, and you said that. I thought I was watching a rerun.
Oh no, that was a rerun. Depending on where you were listening to the first part of the show.
Are you Mandela-ing me in real time?
No. So the TFR, if something goes wrong with TFR, we have so many back shows that they'll just pick one at random, and usually something fairly recent, and they'll play it. And so people were writing me saying, okay, it's a rerun on. It's like, oh, crap. So
I was in a meltdown. I was like, oh, really? I'm actually talking chat in real time, but you had a former show. That's the one thing I can't figure out about like a lot of this streaming is.
That got me one time to where I was listening to the beginning of the show and I was hearing the drums and I was playing along with the drums. And then all of a sudden my voice comes in and I'm not talking. And I'm like going, what the hell?
Dude.
You know, what is this? Yeah, I know. I was having, it was just
freaking
me out. It kind of
spins you up. It spins you up a little bit because like you're having like this moment in time. You're like, I think this is real. And then, like, for the longest time, this is just me being old, but it's like discerning between the premieres and like actual live streaming. And then you're sitting there sitting in the live stream chat and you realize, you know, this happened a day ago. So, like, it's kind of a mind fuck, you know, as you get through it. But
it is.
Anyway,
Peanut said that we did deliberately just for you. Anyway, any shout outs?
Shout out to Spicy and Griff, Fathead out there, Bax. We're gonna go out there and do a thing on the Front Range, and then I'm gonna move Spicy and Griff down to the Carolinas in a big long road trip, and you know, it's just gonna be a real interesting summer, and I'm so glad I've met all you guys, and it just keeps getting better and better every day, and okay, bye.
All right, see you, man. Hopefully we'll see him. Hopefully later. I'll see him after the show. All right. I am smart enough not to pick up 484 because I know they're just listening. And let's jump over to 343 in the wonderful, magical land of Canada. Yes. Don't forget, Americans live in America. Canadians live in Canada. Yeah, they do. All right, Canada, what do you got? Talking to you. Line unmuted. We really got to get that fixed. Hey, Ontario. All right, fine. I was going to say 343. All right, let's go out to... Oh, you know what? Let's go back out to California. 510, line unmuted. What is happening, man? Oh, it sounds like he's driving.
Can you hear me?
He's at a party.
Lathaniel, where are you?
In my car.
With the window down?
Nah, what a cheap earpiece.
You're coming in pretty loud there, Lathaniel.
Yeah, but is that better? Is that better?
Yeah, a little better. Sure.
Yes, yeah, that's better.
Car.
It's all right, you're good.
This is kind of symbolic, man. This was my first official day back at my job, calling in like I used to, so. Yeah, but But how y'all been?
So what's new?
Life is great.
Oh, good.
Can't complain. Want to hear y'all beautiful voices. My freaking big brother Mark looked like a freaking stud. Proud of that guy. If he can turn,
he's down under 210 pounds. That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, man. Sure, he started putting me to shame a little bit.
Yeah. Holy smokes.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Looking good, man. Looking real good. I guess he's getting ready for that swimsuit edition.
Yes. The Flat Earth calendar. The beefcake edition. Absolutely.
There you go. That's perfect. But no, man, I just wanted to call and reach out. I'll say this much. If I ever really want to catch up on some non-biased news, man, this is always the best platform to come to. So, yeah, I just want to put that out there.
Thank you. Do it again. Well, cool.
Yeah, okay. But I know it's a little nausea on my end. I'll try to see if I can get in on the after show and try to catch up a little bit more then. But I just want to tell you that I love y'all, man. I miss you all. And before you want California to go off into the waters, man, let me get to St. Louis first, huh?
Okay.
All right.
All right, man.
Good hearing from you. I love you, God. Love you. Love you. Talk to you later.
Love you too. 11-11.
11-11.
11-11.
You don't know what that means. You got to look it up. Should we stay out in California? Sure. 669, still out in California. Line unmuted. What's happening?
All right. That's me.
Hey.
California.
What's up? Hey.
So, you got time for a little thought exercise?
As long as it's not too long, sure. Go ahead.
All right. So let's say we're gonna draw some perimeters here. say you're gonna draw a perimeter around like an entire county, you know. So can you draw a smaller perimeter around the outside of that perimeter? No.
No.
So let's say you draw a perimeter around the entire state. Can you draw a smaller perimeter around the outside of that perimeter? No.
No.
Okay, about the entire country. Can you draw a smaller perimeter? No. All right, how about the entire continent you live in? Can you draw a smaller perimeter on the outside of that one? No, you can't draw a smaller perimeter on the outside of the perimeter. Right?
Yeah.
So the entire northern hemisphere? What if you draw a perimeter around all of that, like 24,000 miles perimeter? Can you draw a smaller perimeter on that?
I would say no, given so far what you've been doing.
Okay, well, that's the thing. You can't draw a smaller perimeter around another perimeter. However, if they want us to think that living on a globe, there's going to be a certain point where you're going to have to be able to do that. Which seems like it doesn't make sense, obviously, because the globe is bullshit. But like this thought experiment, if I really had the time to go over the nuance of it, it completely debunks the globe.
It very well might.
Because you can't expand out and have another center point. You know, it's not going to happen. The more you expand out, the bigger it gets. You're never going to shrink back down into a center point somewhere else. It's impossible. It goes against logic entirely. But that's what they'd have you to believe. I mean, I guess that's what they'd have. I'd love to talk to one of these guys.
Go ahead.
You know, am I making sense or is it kind of lost?
No, you are, but don't forget that there are a lot of people in the world that don't do very well at three-dimensional thinking, like what you're talking about, which is why, again, don't forget that 8 inches per mile squared still screws up people to this day.
Oh yeah,
yeah, I know, that's become
all day long, and that's fairly easy. So, and again, it makes perfect sense in your head, and I'm sure you've got this thing solved, but I have heard this many a time over 7 years where people, it's like, I've got it. I can totally blow it away.
Yeah,
and then whatever they're talking about takes three pages, not saying that yours does. But
I need to get someone who can animate well so I can have a visual that goes along with my whole spiel. Because, I mean,
don't forget, if you're going – if you're going to draw this up, if you're going to, and I highly recommend, if you're going to draw this up, pretend that you're talking to a 6-year-old, because if you don't, if you throw anything even remotely complex, people's mouths are just going to drop open and they're going to make chicken noises. you know, they're just going to freeze.
Check it out. Here's something that I've realized over the years, and it's, I kind of figured out in a trying to simplify it, but like the lies begin right where our vision falls, right where our scope falls off. Like we're going, whether you're going small or big, it's like the lies start right where you can't see it anymore, you know?
Right.
Like there's a virus, you can't see it. Oh, there's meteors, but they're further than where you can see it. You know, it's like the bullshit starts right where your scope falls off. It's totally the way it goes. So anytime you have things like ear porn that's coming at you from something that you can't quite see yourself, it's like, I don't think so.
Yeah.
I mean, it's so funny how it is, really. It's like they got it going small and big, you know.
The lies start right the where micro and the macro. Off. Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Yep, yep.
Like I've been saying, I'm about as worried of a virus as I am about a meteor hitting. I'm equally fearful of either, which is not at all.
Yeah. Outer threats haven't bothered me much in quite some time.
Yeah.
Or inner threats, for that matter. Anyway, anything
no
else?
Need to worry about that. Yeah. Nah, that's all I got for out there right now. But... All right.
Well, thank you.
And
again, if you want to draw any of that up and send it to me, I'd be happy to take a look at it.
Cool. Yeah, I'll do that. For sure.
Cool. All right.
I'll get.
Well, hey, have a good one out in California.
Right on,
see you, man.
All right. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Oh, let's pick up. You know what? Let's see what Dennis is doing before the break. 504 line unmuted. Where are you currently driving, Dennis? Somewhere in Oregon, I'm gathering.
Yeah, I'm only in Salem. You caught me early. I'm on my way north. High five.
Cool. Interstate 5, which I will be on Friday, heading to Seattle to meet up with Stefan, hopefully.
Seattle, yes. I'm sending my wife. I'm going to Seattle Sunday. Sending my wife to New Orleans. I'm not going just to, you know, they got the airport there and they got a direct flight. So she doesn't speak English, so it's easier in the airports if I just put her on a direct flight and it's easier. I'll probably come down to New Orleans in October, the week of Oktoberfest, and send her to Honduras because she's been here in the U.S. 6 years and she got citizenship and U.S. passport all now since we last met. So you probably won't see her at Plattoberfest for that reason, but I'll be there. I'll stop off and visit family. Anyway, shout out to Lathaniel. I guess he's driving trucks, isn't he? It's good to hear from you. I hope he's at the best.
Go ahead.
I got his phone number. I'll send him a message. I think we were talking at the one 2 years ago when Greenville, and he came up and butted in to say hi to me because we first met in Denver. So anyway, speaking of him, I'll try and wrap this up. There's a I had mentioned the Communist Party USA, and I was, without going into that, I was very disappointed with it. And for some years now, it's a big, it's not radical and all. And I just mentioned in connection with Nathaniel, there's a African American historian who's very prolific and militant. Gerald Horn's his name, who's the big exception to that. And he's on a program regularly, you might know, as an alternative to Russia Today. It's called Radio Sputnik. They may take down that, too, in the U.S., but Gerald Horn is sometimes a commentator on that. And he's all pro-Russia to the core, unlike even some of the idiots in the Communist Party of USA Today. But another leftist who with similar views, Caleb Maupin, it just reminded me that He made a comment, I mentioned it a couple of years ago, that his opinion, during the Obama years, the ruling class in the United States, the families with most of the money, the 1%, in mass, they shifted political loyalty from the Republicans to the Democrats. And that's why many things go along with that. But you see, during the Cold War and for many decades, the Republicans were the ones that hated Russia, and now it's the Democrats. Well, when did that change more than any other time? During the Obama administration. So you got a lot of these old communist books that are, I mean, the really militant pro-Stalinist ones that are really great stuff. I mean, who are highly informed, I'll say that.
All right. Very cool. Any shout-outs?
Let's see, what's Nathaniel, Ted Summer, Dan, what's David Foster. I could think of, anyway, I'm just looking to seeing all the guys again at Flatoberfest and what's wrapping this up. I got a busy week, and I guess you got two.
Yeah. All right, well, hey, man, it's nice talking to you, and drive safe, okay?
Will do. Appreciate it.
All right. Yep.
Later, Dennis.
All right. So let's pick up at least one more call before the break. Let's go out to Pennsylvania, not to be confused with Transylvania. 570 area code, line unmuted.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
How's it going?
Good. What's going on with you?
Yeah. So, a couple things. Anyway, Philadelphia, they're going to have indoor mask mandates come April 18th.
I saw that. I'm still trying to work that one out. Why Philadelphia of all places?
You know, whatever. It's insanity. But
we'll see if that sticks.
Aside from that, I had a flat earth thing, too. You know, in the beginning of the show, you said thousands of miles wide. You know, I just got to thinking. I was like, "How many?" You know. So,
that's why I say thousands. That's why I say thousands because I don't want to nip that. Go ahead.
You know Samuel Robotham, right?
Oh yeah, heard the name a few times.
Synthetic astronomy. Well, anyway, he in one of his writings, he said that it's approximately 52,800 miles circumference inside the ice shell, the ice wall.
Yeah.
So if that's the case, you know, and Rob Skiba did some stuff on Admiral Byrd, and supposedly he traveled from the ice shell 3,000 miles, and then they, like, packed up and then did the Antarctic Treaty. So if it's 3,000 miles from the ice shell to the dome, you know, doing the math, that would make it approximately 71,647 miles in circumference.
Yeah.
So
that might work out.
You know,
now what that means as far as diameter, I'd have to actually pull it up on a calculator to the diameter of it. But
Diameter would be 22,806, and the radius would be 11,403.
Sure. Yeah.
Oh.
11,000-foot radius?
The radius, not the diameter.
Yeah, but the radius...
From the North Pole to the outside of the ice shelf.
Yeah. It, again,
what was the bigger number you said?
The bigger number would be the 20.
All the way around the outside, you know, all the way around the outside inner dome would be 71,647.
If you included 3,000 mile thick worth of the perimeter is what Peanut's saying. If you included the 3,000 miles thick worth of Antarctica on all sides. Yeah, potentially. Sure.
Yeah.
I'm still not changing the intro from thousands of miles, but thank you for clarifying.
Yeah, I was just like, you know, I'm wondering how many thousands, and it, you know, just
believe it or not, not that many people ask that. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, you know, with doing the calculation with Samuel Robotham and what Admiral Byrd allegedly traveling 3,000 miles, kind of, you know, approximately what it could be. You know, I'm not saying that's exact, but
yeah, I hear you.
Yeah, man. Well, hey, April 18th.
any shout outs? We're going to break here in a little bit.
Shout outs to you guys, and I don't know if you heard this breaking story. I mean, you mentioned something about water, but there's another one that Cove could stand for cobra venom.
It's related. I know.
Oh, stop it.
You know? I know. I know. I know. Anyway. You know,
that's what they're injecting.
We'll probably talk a little bit about this when we come back from the break, just to get it out of everybody's system, because
just check out Brian Artis.
All right. All right. Anyway, man, hey, we're going to break. Thank you. Talk to you.
You are now tuned into the Truth Frequency.
Your protection from deception. TFR.
Truth Frequency Radio.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 4 of 4. It's you, me, Karen B, and last minute guest and longtime listener of the show on episode 350, Zulu One. What's happening, Zulu?
Hello, Karen. Hello, Mark. How are you this evening? Yeah, crazy. Episode 350. Holy cow.
Holy cow. Who would have thought? And people, if you're just listening to this for the first time, don't forget, this is a weekly show. This isn't like a Joe Rogan, our 1,200 episode or whatever. No, it's a weekly show. So yeah, 350 weeks later, that's a lot. That's a lot.
Yeah. I think my first time was episode 29. And then, Karen, you came on, what, around 180? So you've been here forever, too? Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Holy crap. I can't believe it's just so many. I love it. I love it. Every week. This helps me with my sanity because the world sucks.
Well, it's not so. It hasn't turned into complete. I mean, it's all relative. It's not completely clown world yet, but we're.
Yeah, it is. Cobra water. What the fuck?
Okay. All right. Let's talk about this so that people can stop sending me emails and forwarding me this damn video.
Yeah.
Okay. There is a video that's been out. It's only been out a day, right? Where who's the name of the show? The guy that's hosting this damn thing. He's been I can't remember the name of the guy. The show that's been hosting.
Stu Peters.
Okay.
Stu Peters.
Somebody came out to Stu and says, "I think I found the ultimate connection about, you know, the whole virus thing, and they're tying it to snake venom." And with a whole bunch of symbolic references and the fact that it could be in the drinking water, just the water supply. And what I've been trying to tell people lately, and first off, it's the segment, and then they premiered it. They did a teaser trailer for it, and then they premiered it. And There's too much dramatic music in the background. There was too much hype. If it was an actual bombshell thing, you would just drop it with as little production value as possible and say, okay, this is what I found out. Share this with all your friends. Get it out there, down and dirty, and get it out. But this there was too much polish on this. And first thing I was saying, okay, first off, it's too little too late. The fact that you would try to tie this to Snake Venom 2 years later, and it's like, what are you telling us for now? It's a little late to be throwing that out there. And second, yeah, it was
utterly ridiculous.
If it was true, I appreciate the whole symbolism thing, the deep symbolism that's entrenched in it. But the other thing is, if it was true, then we would have friends. I would know people that would have had blood clot issues without ever getting the shot. And we have not seen any of that at all. It's just not happened. I mean, it's like I would have known people. It's like, yeah, I'd have three of my toes cut off because of blood clots. It's like, yeah, but you never even got the shot. And they'd be like, yeah, I know, right? How weird.
It's just another story.
It's obvious. It is a great distraction. And you can tell, like Karen was saying, when it goes viral that fast, and there, you know, there's so many different avenues. I mean, when I got it, if it's sent to me,
because they allowed it to go viral.
Yeah,
exactly.
If it shows up in my email box 10 times in a morning, then I know that, you know, from all different demographics, including my own godmother, who was in her 80s. That's like, yeah.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
It's the snake water.
Yeah, the snake water. No, it's very catchy. I get it. Very, very catchy. Now, could there be something, you know, could there be an inkling of truth in it? Sure. Maybe a little bit, but it's not some bombshell, you know, smoking.
They put fluoride in the water. Fluoride in the water, and it's calcifying everybody's pineal glands, making everybody docile. So maybe if you're drinking city water or tap water, maybe you should stop doing that. Maybe you should drink reverse osmosis water or spring water.
Yeah.
Or distilled water. Water that doesn't have fluoride in it. Get the fluoride out of your water.
If that's what you're worried about. But there's no point of anyone really getting worked up over this story because, again, it's 2 years later. If you want – something was in the water, even if it was true, there's nothing you're going to be able to do about it. So I just kind of shrugged my shoulders. And it's like, yeah, if this story would have come out a year ago or 18 months ago, it would have way more impact than now. But now it's like, it's just a distraction. That's all it is. And a very, remember, don't forget what I have said, which is if it's a simple narrative, you'll know when it's the narrative because it's so simple and catchy that everybody gets it. Cobra water, really? Cobra water? Mm-hmm. Cobra King water? King Cobra water and all the other. There was also a secondary snake, and I can't remember what the name was, but anyway, it was ridiculous. So please, I appreciate that everyone's getting all excited about this one, and I don't even like the you know what it kind of reminded me of, but it was different in that it was kind of like the no trees on flat Earth video. How many times that was sent to me? Many, many, many times.
That was annoying. That drove me nuts.
I didn't hate that video, and I was thank God they somebody, you know, there were different versions because the original audio was so terrible. But this one is being sent to me by people that don't normally send me stuff. So no.
Oh yeah, yeah. This one definitely hit mainstream, and everybody's like, oh my god, the water.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I'm seeing it in some.
It's just ridiculous. It's utterly ridiculous. I was looking today, as from January 12th of 2020 to now, we've had 6.2 million deaths attributed to COVID. It's ridiculous.
Really?
Worldwide. Yeah. It's ridiculous.
Yeah,
and then I looked up flu. The flu is at an unusually low rate right now, and they don't know why.
Right.
It's fucking ridiculous. Yeah. And children have died from flu now, which is weird, because they didn't start even counting that until 2004, 2005, when it was as low as 37 children a year dying around the world, and now it's thousands.
Yeah.
So, you know, I mean, nothing to see here, people. Nothing to fucking see here, people.
Yeah. The
it's ridiculous.
I'm a little surprised at the Philadelphia thing when that story came out. Because and of course, law of averages, there's going to be one or two cities, probably not a state, which is why, you know, the mayor said, well, you know what, we should buck the trend and we should go back on, you know, lock people down again. It's like, I don't know how well that's going to go over in Philadelphia. I don't think it's going to be a trend, though, because there are too many Americans. They're like, OK, let's just knock all this crap off so we can get back to normal.
Yeah.
You know, and start up.
Well, they're trying to sneak that shit in everywhere.
Yeah.
People are still wearing masks.
People still wear masks. So that kind of that's the part that has me worried that if they try to pull that bullshit again, that people will go for it.
Some will. Yes. Yeah. No question. There will be people out there that will just be like, okay, it's that time again. Good thing I didn't, you know, let my guard down. But I'm personally in the camp of they're going to go the other distraction, the bigger distractions. But again, right now, the Americans aren't going for the Ukraine thing. They're just not. It's gotten, even on CNN, it's not even the lead story.
Yeah. Well, that footage is so horrible. I mean, even regular people are like, what is that?
Yeah.
Those aren't even Russian tanks. What are they talking about? The guy said they blew up seven Russian tanks and they're not even Russian. What the fuck?
Or the generals that they keep supposedly wiping down. What people for anyone that is listening to this for the first time, do not forget the Americans really only fight for revenge. That's all we've ever known to do. It is our thing. Seriously, that's any other revenge. Reason. Any other reason we just
my
don't
brother.
Yeah, you do. We don't go for it. We do not bite for it. So people like, no, you know, I know the media. I know that there's a lot more media now than there was in the late 1930s. But showing people, it's like, oh, you can say Ukraine 20 times a minute on all media things, you know, for days on end. They don't care. Look, we let all of Europe burn in the 30s, and we still weren't going over. I mean, all of it was on fire. And it was like, yeah, it's so far away, and we're pretty happy over here. Things are fine. Yeah. It's like, leave the war
there's
over
people
there.
On boats.
Yeah, it's like, really? We don't want to. What? Yeah. So that's what they're gonna have to do. They're everything else isn't working, so they're gonna have to go back to the old tricks because the Americans just aren't going for it. And if the Americans go, and the Americans have to go for it because no one else is going to go in. You're not going to see England or France or anybody else say, oh, let's help them out. You know, Poland, you know, none of that's going to happen. The Americans have to go in before this thing gets serious, and they won't be able to convince them to do it without something weird happening, which kind of waiting for. So Master
right,
Gunner and I have
on a grander scale.
Yeah, something on a grander scale, something which you can really, really hype up, sink your media teeth into. And because right now the media, don't forget, the media can't even go into Ukraine right now. Now it's pretty much sealed off, which is weird. Oh, which was, you know, let me bring up this thing that Karen sent me earlier in the week, which was she sent me Boris Johnson just taking this leisurely stroll through Kiev, right, with his with his bodyguards outside of the cars.
With
right?
Zelensky. You know, it was Boris and Zelensky.
Yeah, yeah. Boris and Zelensky were just kind of walking through. Neither of them were wearing helmets or body armor. They had three black security vans. I'm sure they were British. Off in the distance. But they weren't that close to them. It's not like they were within, you know, a couple hops away. They, you know, they and no one was worried about anything.
No,
and
that was
Master
bullshit.
And they're like waving, and there's nobody on the street. It's like, who
like
are you waving
Gunner
to?
Said.
Right. I mean, there were a few people. You don't know if those people were kind of staged for effect, but there was absolutely no threat in the city.
What did Master Gunner say, Mark?
Master Gunner. Well, he made a point. He's like, yeah. He goes, you notice how there's no weapons around where these guys are walking. He goes, you know, it's like these
guys
weren't gonna...
holding weapons though.
Well, no. It's the big stuff. The big stuff.
No, those are the big stuff.
These guys weren't going to be walking next to anything that could get hit by anything else. So they weren't going to walk up to an anti-aircraft missile system and tap it on the side and kick the tires and go, hey, this looks pretty solid. No, you're not going to do that because any of those things that are in Ukraine are just getting hammered. And so that's why Kiev is, you know, and Master Gunner was saying, he was pointing out the fact where that there was no rubble where these guys were walking.
Where's the destruction?
He goes, where's the smoke?
I thought it's wartime.
Yeah, it's like this place was clean. I mean, it was really, really clean where these guys were walking. And so, and the other thing which I brought up.
It just looked like an abandoned city.
Yeah.
Like every soldier they've shown in every video looks pristine clean, like they just took their uniform out of the package. Not for nothing, but nobody took cover that day. Nobody hit the ground in a firefight. Yeah. What the fuck?
And also, you know, the Prime Minister of the UK, how'd he get there? Exactly. Well, how did he fly in from England? Where did he land and then just drive in? I mean, the Russians were tracking him. Obviously, you know, they've got a massive intelligence network. They knew exactly where he was. And so I think at one point they were watching this going, you know, he could just take that plane out whenever he wanted, or helicopter, or however the hell he got there. But then they thought, no, because if we do that, they're just going to blame it. You know, they're going to make up something and say we shot them over the English Channel.
That was filmed in
the
same studios they filmed Star Wars in England.
Yeah, they will make something up. But anyway, I thought it was very interesting because the mainstream media, Karen, did not run a lot on that story. It should have been, you know, it should have been a big shock. The only follow-up they said was, yeah, Biden's not going to be going to Kiev. It's like, of course he's not. You are not. First off, he is not one. There's no leisurely stroll through the city with this guy. I mean, I wouldn't even put him on a Segway. I'd put him on a. In fact, I'd just leave him in the car. If you're gonna do that.
Yeah, exactly. Just leave him in the car.
By the way,
Grandpa in the car.
Leave Grandpa in the car.
Grandpa can't ride a Segway.
Yeah, he was not going to be walking, which is sad because it's like, you know, these guys were just walking through, you know, a city. It was
disgusting. That's our president, and he's a fucking diaper-wearing moron. What the fuck is this show? What is this show?
Reminds me, if you guys haven't looked it up, and I probably should be able to quote the name of the video that I sent you guys in Funky Bunch chat, but I think it was a Middle Eastern team, comedy team, which made fun of a Biden press thing with Kamala, whatever. She was behind. You know, they were making fun of him. I have never seen that before outside of. Now, American media makes fun of presidents all the time. That's what they do. I have never seen a foreign comedy team make fun of our president before. That's where we are. To where, you know, and the of course, it was the obvious, you know, Biden falling asleep at the podium and Kamala helping him with all the answers and trying to wake him up. And Kamala was played by a guy, which didn't help.
Oh, that's not that far-fetched.
That's where we are, which is that if you want to start something, if you want to do the whole double dog dare, if you want to start saber rattling, one of the first things you do is you make – deliberately, you make your opponent look ridiculous. You know, it's like, oh, is these we America? They aren't America, the one we knew. It's who are these guys? Because again, if you met with Biden on a regular basis and had a press conference with him, you could go look over and it's like, what the hell? what happened? What happened, USA?
Like, is this for real?
Yeah,
you guys are fucking punking me, man. This
you used to be somebody. Now who the hell are you?
Right? At least he was an angry old racist dude before. Yeah, now he's nothing.
Yeah, get now off my porch. You know, one of those
now he's
guys.
Clueless. Corn Pop told me to go shoot off the porch and scare the people away or some shit. I don't remember what the fuck you're talking
about.
At least
an angry white guy, you know, angry old white guy, you know, shaking his fist. You know, when he tries to do that, he just comes off as freaking creepy. You know, when he does that thing in the microphone, it's like, yeah, man. Yeah. You know, he raises his volume for no apparent reason during the middle of sentences.
Or he whispers for no reason. So weird.
We did that. Weird.
Yeah. It's bizarre because, I mean, obviously we know it's all a fucking show. Right. But, I mean... what the hell? It is the most pathetic display of a person in charge. What is going on? Yep. My 16-year-old son would be a better president. What
yeah,
the fuck?
But again, we'll go to the higher level because I'm sure there's people thinking it's like that's what the world order wants. I call them just the world order nowadays because come on, there's nothing new about it.
It's not new. It's
not new. Going it's on, just right? the world order. New? They're redoing things, but it's not new stuff. But that's what they want. They want the big showdown. They want the big fight. And making America look silly. Again, this was no different than, and I don't want to go into boring history stuff for you. This is how, don't forget that back in the day, Spain used to be a thing. Spanish Empire, that was a thing. Yeah. And they're not anymore. And what happened was they got weakened. It was Spain and France and England. They just beat on each other constantly. It was this big triangle of horribleness. And then eventually Spain was the odd man out, and they got so weak that America looked at them. It's like, yeah, you know what? I think we could take stuff from Spain. They're not going to do anything. Let's just go take it. And they did. America just went into the turn of the century and said, yeah, well, you know what? Philippines, ours. Guam, ours. Puerto Rico, yeah, we're taking that too. And Spain could do nothing. They could do absolutely nothing. And that's what they're kind of doing with us now. Where they're saying, you know, America has a lot of stuff. And if America weakens to a point, again, this is just straight up nature. It's like you show enough weakness, other countries are going to look at you and go, yeah, there's some tasty things over there that we want.
Right. There's a military base here we'd like to take apart. Right?
Yeah.
Or it's, two.
Because let's face it. The only reason... I know we won't have too much time left, but I got to bring this up, which is the only reason that Taiwan hasn't been occupied by the Chinese is because of us. That's it. That's the only reason. Right. It's because we build a lot of stuff there. We make a lot of our plastic dog crap there. And it's one of our manufacturing facilities. And because of that, we put a lot of missile systems there and try to beef up their military. And now China's thinking, yeah, I think we can just take it.
And right, they can absolutely take it. We're not going to send people.
No, we're not going to do anything. Fight. We're not going into the China Sea. We can posture. And there's some headlines I didn't read tonight where America's going, oh, you know, there'll be consequences if you do that.
Yeah, uh-huh. We won't buy any of your cheap crap anymore. Oh,
yeah, right. Yeah. I think Walmart is like half their income.
Yeah.
Yeah. Amazon. Half the shit from Amazon is Chinese.
Yeah, Amazon too. Yeah.
Yeah, crazy. We would crazy. Be the made in America would mean a whole different thing if things turned to that route. And so yeah, they don't know what to do. And the sanctions, you got to remember that they won't even, you know, sanctioning Russia, that's people just sanction Russia for the hell of it. Sanctioning China, ooh, they're not the, I don't know what would happen there. You know, because they're already, you know, what we talked about some weeks ago, where some of the cities they're locking down coincidentally have to do with manufacturing our stuff. Right. I don't think they're just locking it down because they just want to mess with their people. It's like, oh, yeah, isn't that city make iPhones? Yeah, lock that down. Mm-hmm. and it's like right. the people right. are getting punished, but it's the Americans is what they're going after. Like, no iPhones for you for a couple months.
Oh, yeah, these are all strategic. Every single one of these shutdown closures and mask bullshit.
Yep.
Ridiculous.
Yep.
Such a show.
That's where we're kind of at. Everyone's pieces are moving around the board. Nobody's really, you know, going for broke yet. The Finland thing could be interesting. We'll see if that happens. That could be a hot point. But even then, you know, how much time we got left? I have enough time to bring this up. Look. America, I wasn't kidding. I wasn't being funny when I said that America only fights for revenge. But if Russia invaded Finland, just came out and just rolled into Finland, would they be condemned? Sure. Would all of a sudden people, you know, troop ships started heading over to Finland? No. No. I will say this. Americans have a better chance of at least pointing on a map where Finland is. They'd probably get it wrong compared to Ukraine. They have no idea where Ukraine is. They just point somewhere in the Eastern Bloc and they'd have no idea. Finland, at least you have one of three chances. Finland, Sweden, or Norway. You have a one in three chance of guessing which one it is. Just so you guys know, it's the one that borders Russia.
That's one of the Icelandic countries.
Yeah. Yeah. And... yeah, so having them do a crash course into NATO, which it's all it is the U.S. cool kids club. That's all it is. NATO is not anything super special. Without us, I mean, we were the ones that organized it. And the whole reason it's there is because, hey, we need a club so we can justify putting all our stuff in different places. Yeah.
NATO's terrible. Even our own troops hate them. All the troops hate that whole organization. They're just rotten. They play like they're nice and humanitarian, but they do such dirty, dastardly shit all around the globe.
Yeah.
You like and what I did there? Globe.
As I do. I did. I saw that. And as much as I would like to, you know, I used to say, you know, it was one of the running jokes is if you want to not get hassled, just when you're over traveling, just say you're Canadian instead of American because, you know, they get hassled much, much less. But nowadays, I know.
Yeah. I saw a video of an American in Pakistan, and the guy was like, oh, you're American? You're a terrorist. And he's like, what? He goes, yeah, you guys are the worst. You just kill everybody. It was so funny. I was like, that's right. Tell them, fucking people.
Anyway, hey, we're winding down the show. So any little things you want to say, Zulu? Or?
Yeah, okay. I have a quote.
Yeah.
The fear of death follows from the fear of life. A man who lives fully is prepared to die at any time. So let's try and live our lives because this world is crazy stupid.
Enjoy it. Again, the flat earthers know better. We're the ones that are doing conferences. We're the ones that are doing meetups.
Flattoberfest. Yep. You better be there, Mark.
Dude,
I'll pick you up at the fucking airport if I have to, but you better be there.
Well, you may have to anyway because I'm not going to rent a car when I'm down there.
Yeah.
But yeah.
We'll get you. No, we'll get you, Mark. You know we got you.
All right.
I will get you.
Anyway, yeah, enjoy. And yeah, all flat earthers, I think they're kind of working through this. You know, we've dodged most of the bullets so far and everything. We're hanging tough. Again, it was really great to see, for example, last thing before we wind this thing down. It was really great to see all the flat earthers pushing 1,000 of them in the chat room when Dave was, you know, going up against Professor.
Sticking it to that a-hole.
Yeah. I mean, and again, it was great because we were just dominating it. And I was putting it in chat all the time. It's like, hey, freaking Professor Dave, guys, where are you? Where the hell are? Oh, right. You're not there because you're freaking phantoms. Again, if you guys don't know what I'm talking about, watch the documentary called Fake Famous. It'll tell you everything you want to know about.
There was two mods and they were like, oh my God, what's going on? Where is everybody? How come? Because there is nobody.
There is nobody. Yeah. I was stunned. It's like 2 million. Come on. We find me a flat earther with 300,000 subs. But this guy's got 2 million. He's one of two trolls. Between him and I don't even know how many the other guy has over in England. Simon Dan. I should probably look that up. Anyway, okay, we're going to roll this thing out. Any shout-outs, Zulu?
Yes. Shout-out to Karen B., Mark Sargent, Peanut Gallery, my little brother, Nathaniel. I'm going for the flat firefighter calendar, by the way.
Awesome. And we'll be back next week. Same flat time, same flat channel. Because I forgot, we're going to sing my way out. Ready? Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it with
New
True
York,
Snacks.
New York.
Trail Mix Supreme. Yeah.
Nice.
All right. Anyway, say goodnight, Karen.
Good night, Karen.
Say goodnight, Zulu.
Night, Zulu.
And as always, hot set.
Hot set. Cold tech. All the tech. Love you guys. Bye.
Take care.
ever been. And I'm so tired of being on the ropes again. That's the lovely girl standing on the moon.
Need. There's love so many.